All right, for stepping music, yeah. Soul Train, all right. Your next contestant, ladies and gentlemen, representing Heart of America, contestant number 21, Terry Damore.
I'm a diva. Is a female version of the
How you doing, Chicago? How y'all feeling out there? Happy Easter! Okay, before I start my little thing, can we first, because we all experienced history last year, can we give it up for Barack Obama, y'all? Give him a hand. He made history. Okay, but he wasn't the only one that made history. As all of you may know, last year, I made history. I was the only contestant in continental history to win talent and not make the 12. So give me a hand. Give me a hand. Oh, yeah, yeah, Barack Obama, we both made history. That's my baby boo. But you know what? Everyone been asking me, girl, what happened? How did you make the win talent and not make the 12? Y'all want to know what happened? I said, do y'all want to know why I didn't make the 12? Okay, if you may recall last year, I blamed everything that go wrong in my life on George Bush. But after 2 weeks of doing the pageant, when I got my score sheets, I realized it wasn't George Bush. It was these damn judges, baby. Baby, let me tell you something. It all started with interview. Now, that's the part you all do not get to see. Now, when I walked in there, they start asking us all of these irrelevant questions. Now, if I was Tommy Ross and I had five fat bras sitting in front of me, I wouldn't be asking them no political question. I would be trying to get the secrets to some recipes. If I was Tommy Ross, I would have said, now, Miss Terry, how many cheeses do you put in your macaroni to give it that kick? How you doing? But you know what? It wasn't just Tommy the head judge, Skip Mackerel. He wanted to know, why should you be Miss Continental Plus? And I said, because I'm fat. Could you think of any other reason to be Miss Continental Plus? What Skip should have asked was, Miss Terry, how many cups of sugar does it take to make a pound cake? And I would have told him, a pound. That's why it's called a pound cake. Baby. Oh, baby. Then we get to the part that I'm sure you all saw, which evening gown. Oh my God. I looked at my score sheets and one of the judges said that I didn't walk my gown elegant enough. I didn't walk it with confidence. Well, baby, after leaving KFC eating a 10-piece to myself, putting on a girdle and a corset, wearing 6 ounces of makeup, 10 pounds of hair, 4-inch stiletto heels, and you want me to walk the gown elegant and with confidence? Baby, you ought to be glad I was even able to walk. Then they said, okay, I should have walked and modeled a little more elegant. That's what another judge said. But baby, we're coming up from all those stairs in the back. The last thing I'm thinking about is walking the gown elegant. When I come up from all those stairs in the back, baby, I need a glass of Sprite. Then we get to the part. Swimsuit, oh my God. I guess because I look like Halle Berry in the face and thick in the waist, they started scoring me the way they scored the small girls in Continental. So one of the judges, now mind you, they said I didn't walk elegant enough. Now they say for swimsuit, I didn't walk fast enough, that I wasn't going with the beat. Well, baby, let me tell you something, judges. The reason why I didn't walk fast with my swimsuit, because the way my thighs rub together when I walk, I would have set this place on fire. Trust me, you may not appreciate it, but I guarantee your insurance company appreciate me not walking fast in my swimsuit, baby. So I started tallying up the scores, And I realized, I said, you know what? My tallyation does not coincide with what whoever tallied up the scores for Continental. So I said, you know what, let me call Jim Flint because I think I made the 12. And he didn't call my name. So I called the baton, I said, Mr. Flint, somebody tallied up the scores wrong. He said, who is this? I said, it's Terry DeMore, the talent winner that did the 12. But when I tallied up the scores, I made that 12. And Jim Flint said, Terry, don't get upset. You did make the 12. It was just the bottom 12. Baby. So, wait a minute, y'all. So I just want to serve a notice to Jimmy and to all the judges. Baby, y'all can't keep throwing me in the bottom because I am not no bottom. I am a top.
Number 21, Terry DeMore. The bottom 12, you go, bitch. Change with Obama. Change stands for Continental has another night of great entertainment. And we're ready to go. Representing Purple Angel Continental, this is contestant number 22, Allison Knight.
Mr. Roboto.
Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number 22, Allison Knight. I gotta remember to buy batteries. Fabulous. Set up. Okay. At this time, ladies and gentlemen and judges, representing Kentucky Continental, this is contestant number 23, Alex Chandra. Let me hear it out there.
All aboard.
Train to Chicago, boarding on track number 6.
All aboard.
Them that's got shall get. Them that's not shall lose. So the and it still is news. Mama may have, Papa may have, but God bless a child that's got his own, that's got his own. My name, you got lots of friends crowding round your door. When you're gone and spent, they don't come no more.
Next stop, Chicago.
Everybody, spread the word. Georgia Brown will tear up this town.
Now Major's got a shade on. I'll tell you just why. You know I don't lie. Well, not much. Ben said she knocked some dead when she left in town. Since she came, why? It's a shame how she cools them down. Georgia named her, Georgia claimed her, sweet Georgia Brown. No gal made him got a shame on sweet Georgia Brown. Well, that beef and all song he has, sweet Georgia Brown. They'll sign and what's died for, sweet Georgia Brown. I'll tell you just what.
Contestant number 23, ladies and gentlemen, make some noise. Let's hear it out there for Alexandra.
Okay. Left a suitcase at the depot.
Representing West Virginia Continental, please help me welcome to the stage contestant number 24, Roxy Andrews.
I remember when I lost my mind. There was something so pleasant about that place. Even your emotions have an echo in so much space. And when you're out there without care, yeah, I was out of touch. But it wasn't because I didn't know enough. I just knew too much.
You tell me what's bothering you, sure.
I just feel so useless, so powerless. I can't stop eating. Every day I try and try. And every day I go off. I can't even look at my own vagina. I wish I had courage to just get it over with and get really fat.
I'm too young to be old, and I'm too old to be young. Maybe I'm just going crazy.
Does that make me crazy?
Closed out by your husband.
That's my life savings. How can that be when I got the passbook right here?
That was what we call a custodial savings account. That means either parent can countersign, make a withdrawal.
But this doesn't show any withdrawals. How'd he get the money without the goddamn passbook?
According to this, he asked to be issued a new one. It's common enough.
Common be damned. I opened this account. Who the hell you think put the money in the bank to begin with?
Please, Mrs. St. George. I'm sorry, but I assure you that what we did was not only legal, but standard bank practice.
Well, maybe it's legal and maybe it ain't. What I can't believe is that standard bank practice means you don't even make one single goddamn phone call to the person whose name and number's on top of this account?
I'm very sorry, but...
You say you're sorry one more time and I'll kick your butt up so high you'll look like a hunchback. I'm a woman, ain't it? If it'd been the other way around, if I'd been the one passing off a fairy story how I'd lost a passbook and asked for a new one, if I'd been the one who started drawing out what took 11 years to put in, you would have called Joe. Suppose it's one of two things. Either he's buried it in a mason jar in the backyard, or else he's opened up a new account. I know you don't have to tell me, but I'm hoping you'll think for just one moment about the grief and heartache you could have saved me by making just one phone call. I'm asking you to please tell me whether he's opened a new account here or if I gotta start digging holes around my house.
Come on, who do you, who do you, who do you, who do you think you are? Ha, 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 bless your soul. You really think you're in control?
Dirty bird. How could you? She can't be dead. Misery Chastain cannot be dead.
Annie, in 1871, women often died in childbirth. Misery's spirit is still alive.
I don't want her dead! I want her! And you murdered her!
No, I didn't.
Who did?
No one. She died. She just slipped away.
Slipped away! She didn't just slip away! You did it! You did it! You did it! You did it! You murdered my misery!
Annie!
I thought you were good, Paul. But you're not good. You're just another lying old dirty birdie. And I don't think I'd better be around you for a while.
And don't even think about anybody coming for you. Not the doctors. Not your agent, not your family, because I never called them. Nobody knows you're here. And you better hope nothing happens to me. Because if I die, you die.
Maybe we're crazy.
Contestant number 24, Roxy Andrews. You go, girl. Take an Ambien, it gets better in the morning.
Ready?
Yep. Ladies and gentlemen and judges, representing Miss Latina Chicago Continental Plus, contestant number 25, Savati Couture.
Y bien ahora me encuentro sola, vuelvo a sufrir, me siento triste. Nadie me quiere, siento morir. ¿Qué me sucede? Ya ni tengo hambre, yo no era así. Siempre jugaba, siempre reía, no era infeliz. Contenta, me doy mucho valor, ahí frente al espejo, la super sexy soy. ¿Qué importa que se burlen? Yo flaca nunca fui, tristeza ya no existe, gordita soy feliz. No existe soledad, no existe. Y gorditos, la vida es normal, claro que soy feliz. Por fin puedo decir que mi belleza no es solo interior. Mi curvilínea estética es de lo mejor. Yo soy la reina de este show.
Podemos sonreír, nadie puede decir que existe algún gordito infeliz. Todos podemos comer, todos podemos beber y nunca preocuparnos de una dieta.
Comer es natural, beber resulta igual, sentirse satisfecho es colosal. Si el corazón contento tú quieres llevar, primero la barriga llenarás.
Thank you.
Number 25 this evening, ladies and gentlemen, Miss Savati Couture. And if you would, a big round of applause for all of our Plus contestants. Let me hear it out there for all of our Plus contestants this evening. Guys. Yes. Oh, Teddy, here we go. Judges, I'd like to remind you to change your books for your elite. Thank you. Your next 12 contestants, ladies and gentlemen, are invited for the title of Continental Elite 2009-2010. We're ready to go. In talent competition, ladies and gentlemen, representing Puerto Rico Continental, this is contestant number one, Lady Charisse.
Behind the gay facade, the streets are cold and hard. The shutters locked and barred. Irma La Douce, alone. A neon painted face, a meaningless embrace. A love that leaves no trace. Irma La Douce, alone. What's the use of trying? Nothing matters anymore. Why this bitter feeling that I never felt before? What's the point of praying when there's nothing to believe? When I build a dream world, it's myself that I deceive. Oh, what have I become? A moment's joy for some. A woman who is numb, Irma La Douce. The fool, he must exist somewhere. The end of this despair. A love I long to share. Irma La Douce. Where are you hiding, Irma La Douce? Where's the happy child that used to laugh and play? Irma La Douce, has she gone away? Irma La Douce, bring her back today. Innocent and pure, she's a girl without a past. I'll bring her back and let her help me find a love to last. Find a man who'll proudly take me on the avenue. Someone to make Paris sing the way it used to do. Where lovers crowd the Seine, we'll watch the boats again. We'll steal a kiss and then, Irma La Douce, we'll sing the 14th of July. The fireworks in the sky, the day I hear him cry, Irma La Douce,
Thank you. Oh, thank you.
There is a role I played a very long time ago that's my favorite. It was in a picture with Dean Martin and Frank Sinatra, and it was called Some Came Running. Do you remember that? This was the first time I'd ever worked with Frank. He played my boyfriend, Dave, who was a writer, kind of an intellectual. And I played Ginny Moorhead, who was his girlfriend. She loved Dave more than life, but he was cruel to her. He would say things to her like, Ginny, you are so goddamn stupid, you haven't got enough brains to come in out of the rain unless somebody leads you. And you'd go any place with anybody because even you know you're a pig. Dave. I don't think you should talk to me like that, you know? No, honestly speaking, I don't think you have the right to talk to me that way. I'm a person too. I'm a human, a someone. To me, I'm important. Not something you spit on or hide in a corner. That got me some rights. So I'm not as smart as you. So what? That don't give you the right to talk down to me, Dave. I'm a person too. You can yell and you can hit me. But don't hurt my feelings. Just let me be with you and talk to me, Dave. So I don't understand you. I just love to listen and hear you talk. So talk to me. Haven't you noticed? I've been talking better lately, and I've been listening better lately. One day, you know I'd do anything for you. Your shirts, your shorts, I'd sew on your buttons, get up every morning and make you your coffee. I'd just do anything you say. Just tell me what you want. That's what I'm gonna do. Tell me every day. But you gotta remember, I'm a person too. Dave, be in love with me. I love you so much. I never met anybody like you before. I've certainly never been in love with anybody like you before. Touch me, you know. I don't know, I fall flat apart. I just fall flat apart. And I just love you so much. I don't know what to do. I just love you. Dave, I'd make you such a good wife.
I mean, you'd never, never be sorry. I'd make you so happy. We could have so much fun. We could have a good time. And the only thing that I'd ask you to do is remember I'm a human. I'm a someone. I'm important. I'm a person too. I'm a person too.
Number one in Elite this evening, ladies and gentlemen. Let's hear it out there for Lady Charisse.
Set up, honey? No.
Representing Southeast Continental Elite, this is contestant number two, Miss Asia Black.
I know this is elite, but I need to show you what I can really do.
Surely miss your tender kiss.
Contestant number two this evening. A true professional, Asia Black. Just so you know, there was no backup music. There was no backup. At this time, ladies and gentlemen, a talent competition. Please meet and greet contestant number three for Continental Elite. This is Daisha Richards.
This is a journey into music and sound. Watch out and get ready to move your feet. Wherever you are, you will be a part of it. Get ready. We'll be right back.
Ladies and gentlemen, number three, Miss Dacia Richards. Your next contestant, ladies and gentlemen, representing Miss Metropolitan Continental Elite. She is contestant number four. Please meet and greet to the stage, Miss Lee Shannon.
I'm
Contestant number four this evening, ladies and gentlemen, Miss Lee Shannon. Also, I'd like to remind you, ladies and gentlemen, we are finished here. We are going back to the baton, so if you'd like to join us, see the most glamorous female impersonators in the world, come on down and join us on Clark Street. Thank you, love. And we're ready to go.
Stop it.
Contestant number five this evening, representing Texas Continental Elite, this is Jamie Perry.
Thank you.
Contestant number five, ladies and gentlemen, is Jamie Perry. Remember, game tomorrow night is the finals four, plus doors open at 7 o'clock. Contest starts promptly at 8 p.m. Also on Tuesday is the finals for the elite contestants at the baton. Doors open at 7, contest promptly at 8 p.m. Your next contestant, ladies and gentlemen, representing Purple Angel Continental Elite, contestant number six. This is Evelyn Thomas.
Cruella DeVille, Cruella DeVille, if she doesn't scare you, no evil thing will. The world was such a wholesome place until Cruella, Cruella DeVille.
Hello, my name is Cruella, Cruella DeVille. I'm always seeing spots in my dreams. There's lots of dots. I despise the sound of barking a cappella. I never am forgetting furs for wearing, not for petting. I'm Cruella, Cruella, Cruella. That's why the guys and gals don't want to be Miss Devil's pals. My hair would even scare most any fella. Fur coats are my great passion. This year's spots will be in fashion. I'm Cruella, Cruella, Cruella. What's black and white and mean all over? That would be none other than me. Beware if you answer to dipstick, dotty or rover. I've got my eyes on every pooch that I see.
I'm beginning to see spots.
Who let the dogs out?
Good evening, madam.
Suspicions are mounting. Police are everywhere. I want the job done tonight. Poison them. Drown them. Bash them on the head. Got any chloroform? I don't care how you kill the little beast. Just do it and do it now.
I'm getting good. Real good. At being bad.
So bad.
I'm at my best when driving people mad. I'm getting good. Being bad.
So bad.
I'm not happy till I'm making someone sad. To do the wrong thing, I think that's so fine. My policy is to moan and cry and whine. When I'm told yes, I've learned to just say no. When I hear stop, to me it's time to go.
Yet. You've won the battle, but I'm about to win the wardrobe. My spotty puppy coat is in plain sight and leaving tracks. In a moment, I'll have what I came for, while all of you will end up as sausage meat, alone on some sad plastic plate, dead and medium red, no friends, no family, no pots, just slapped between two buns, smothered in onions, with fries on the side. Cruella DeVille has the last laugh. Ha 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 ha!
Contestant number six, representing Purple Angel, Evelyn Thomas.
Out the front, Betty.
Representing Heart of America Continental, this is contestant number seven, Amanda Roberts.
Treated me fair and we'd not had a tiff. If you had not said I should go and jump right off the nearest cliff. If you had stayed off the make and you'd never have taken to coming home stiff. If I had not smelled perfume with a nasty unfamiliar whiff. Had the cheek to stay out for a week, saying back at a jiff. If you were not such a two-timing guy. If you weren't, if you hadn't, if you didn't, if you weren't, if you hadn't, if you didn't, but you haven't, you were and you went and you didn't. So goodbye. If I had not seen you take Geraldine on the lake in your flat-bottom skiff. If you were not that with Sue with your arms around her bare midriff. If I had not seen you pen sexy little Gwen in your own hieroglyphs. You would not left me home when you had two seats for South Pacific. I'm gonna miss you, baby. You were too darn prolific. Ah, what's the diff? If you were not such a hound who when game was around always picked up the sniff. If you were not such a two-timing guy. If you weren't, if you hadn't, if you didn't, weren't, if you hadn't, if you didn't, weren't, you haven't, you when you did. And so goodbye. When I asked where you'd been, you had not clipped my chin with a beautiful bin. Hey, yeah. I had not always found purple lipstick on your handkerchief. If you had not told me lies in the look of my eyes with a smile of beauty. If when I caught you with Kate, you had not said it's of no significance. I'm gonna miss you, baby. And I could guess if, oh, what's the diff? If the best years of my life weren't spent as your wife with no marriage or tip. If you were not such a two-timing guy. If you weren't. Shoulda, and you didn't, though you shoulda, if you didn't, if you weren't, if you hadn't, if you didn't, but you weren't, you haven't, you went, and you didn't.
Ladies and gentlemen, number 7, Amanda Roberts. She beat the hell out of him. All right. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, representing Florida Continental, contestant number 8, Tiffany McRae. Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number 8, Miss Tiffany McRae. Representing Missouri Elite, this is contestant number 9, Chris Edwards. Thank you.
clear. I am changing. I'm gonna stop right now, right here. I'm
my life being a color.
Never you agree with me when I saw you kicking dirt in my eyes. Black or white.
Contestant number 9, ladies and gentlemen, Chris Edwards.
Set up now, we're ready to go.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, representing Missouri Continental Elite, this is contestant number 10, Ginger Manchester.
Wow, wow, wow.
I'd like to tell a little story that's been told time and time again about the crazy men who chased me. My scarlet men. They used to tell me they loved me, but I knew better than them. I'd find them sneaking round the corner. My discarded men. Piercing eyes with a vengeance. Tell them to count to ten. They'd tease me with their dime. My discarded men.
when I was making all of those hit records in the 50s and the 60s. You waited until I became 50 years old before you finally gave me a gold record, and this is it. My man, the story of my life.
Ladies and gentlemen, contestant number 10, Ginger Manchester.
Well, they cleaned up the stage by themselves.
Haven't been that many feathers here since Sesame Street in Review. All right.
Ready, Joe?
Ladies and gentlemen, representing Missouri Continental, contestant number 11, this is Jody Santana.
I'm a country girl from head to toe, came a long way down that country road. Neon lights. Now I can fly my dreams around the world, but I'll always be a country girl. I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere, man. Cross the deserts bare, man. I breathe the mountain air, man. And travel, I've hit my share, man. I've been to Reno, Chicago, Fargo, Minnesota, Buffalo, Toronto, Winslow, Sarasota, Wichita, Tulsa, Ottawa, Oklahoma, Tampa, Panama, Natoma, Lapaloma, Bangalore, Salvador, Amador, Amarillo, Little Killer, Amadillo, Amarillo, I'm a killer. I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere, man. Cross the deserts bare, man. I breathe the mountain air, man. I travel, I've had my share, man. I've been everywhere. Boston, Charleston, Houston, Kingston, Texarkana, Monterey, Purdue, Santa Fe, Tallahassee, Glen Rock, Black Rock, Little Rock, Opelousa, Tennessee, Hennessy, Chippewa, Spirit Lake, Grand Lake,
Number 11 this evening, ladies and gentlemen, Jody Santana. And we come down to the last one this evening. Please help me welcome to the stage contestant number 12. This is Michelle Fighter.
Says good night.
It's good, isn't it grand? Isn't it great? Isn't it swell? Isn't it fun? Isn't it nowadays? There's everywhere jazz, everywhere booze, everywhere life, everywhere joy, everywhere nowadays. You can like the life you're living, you can live the life you like, you can eat.
Why don't we paint the town and all that jazz? I'm gonna rouge my knees, roll my stockings down, and all that jazz. Start the car, I know a whoopee spot where the gin is cold but the piano's hot. It's just a noisy hall where there's a nightly roar and all that. Jazz. And all that jazz. And all that jazz. Lick your hair and wear your buckle shoes, and all that jazz. I hear the father dip, it's gonna blow the blues. And all that jazz. Hold on, hon, we're gonna bunny hop. I bought some aspirin down at your nine and draw, in case you shake up what. Want a brand new start to do that.
Of jazz, let's pick up the pace. Let's make the parties longer. Let's make the skirts shorter. Let's all go to hell in a fast car and keep it hot.
Hey.
Ladies and gentlemen, number 12, Michelle Fighter. Great way to end the evening. Remember, ladies and gentlemen, doors open tomorrow evening at 7 p.m. Contest is promptly at 8 p.m. Remember, on Tuesdays, doors open at 7, contest at 8 p.m. at the Baton. Oh, wait a minute. We're doing... Excuse me, judges. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, we are going to redo contestant number 2 in Elite Talent over again. Yes. Yes, come on, let's hear it out there. We're redoing number 2 because of the mess up with the music. Okie dokie. All right. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together in talent. Contestant number 2, this is Asia Black. Number two, ladies and gentlemen, Asia Black. Well, I had an initiation. If it went wrong, it was going wrong tonight. We got through it. Remember, once again, ladies and gentlemen, 7 o'clock, doors open tomorrow, 8 o'clock.